Hello everyone, my name is Chris Lessard and welcome to the Overwatch Contender Season 1 Europe Recap Show. Stay tuned for the top 5 plays, but for now, let's get straight to the games. Our first match was 1-2-3 versus EUnited. Legion Tower went to all 3 maps with EUnited's crews showing off with this Dragonblade.
1-2, we have 3! 1-2-3, just not the way 1-2-3 wanted it.
And this quad kill pulse bomb from Volatalia.
Oh my god! Volatalia!
But 1-2-3 proved too strong, edging EUnited out on Control Center to take an early series lead. It looked like EUnited would stabilize on Eichenwald, halting 1-2-3 with this crew's Volatalia Big Bang.
It's so much damage, man!
1-2-3 hit back with an aggressive defense, but EUnited stopped themselves as they stepped off the payload for too long in overtime.
Putting in
damage, and they landed off the point! It happened again!
Volskaya went to a tiebreaker, but EUnited had a stronger offense and defense, which meant they had plenty of time to get one tick on point A. EUnited sealed up the map win with this crew's counterblade.
Bruce's blade came out first and slices down half a cool in midair. That's what you like to see.
Watchpoint Gibraltar might as well have been a brick wall for EUnited as they showed no respect to the payload, which gave 1-2-3 an easy time taking the map on offense.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
1-2-3 win the series 3-2-1. Up next was Bazooka Puppies versus Cloud9. Nepal went to 2 maps as both teams fought back and forth, but Cloud9 managed their ultimates better to take an early map win. Cloud9 continued their momentum on King's Row, where they held Bazooka Puppies before the finish.
And it is looking like a dead push here for Bazooka Puppies.
Then had no trouble pushing the payload on offense for another map win.
This is going to be too little, too late. The Graviton Surge just for style points at the end of the day.
Hanamura went to a tiebreaker with a large time advantage for Cloud9. They only needed one tick on point B, but it came down to the final minute before Nevix got the puppies in his sights to secure the victory.
I'm not a fan of this one, lad. You just tried to take a fight with the devil. He's on the high ground CP, and he's making mincemeat of them.
The tracking just became a little bit more beautiful there. The tac visor came in. Plenty of room for Nevix.
Bazooka Puppy's Nesh delivered some key Widow kills on Watchpoint Gibraltar.
This is crazy. And he gets the D-mech! Wow, no, that's actually huge!
D-meching D.Va in the hangar that helped the puppies complete the map. Cloud9 didn't know what hit them on offense as Ube was unchained, slicing up Cloud9 at the beginning.
Damage, but it does not matter because Ube is there.
And end of the map.
Does Ube have the Dragonblade? Yes, he does, and now ZP, it's time to strike.
He's growing right in, the blade is out, and it's true! A double, no, triple kill for
Ube! I don't believe it.
In for the Bazooka Puppies!
Cloud9 win the series 3-1. Our next match was Singularity versus Misfits. Despite a 99-99 finish on Shrine, Misfits were in complete control on Nepal.
But Logix, he's an X-Factor.
Yeah, Logix has got something to say about that. When the pulse bomb comes out, Kellex will fall, not before picking up a few more plays of his own. He's a one-man army!
Logix established dominance against Singularity to secure a quick map win for Misfits. Singularity showed promise on Numbani by finishing just meters away from the finish. But Misfits Swoosh got angry.
I mean, Swoosh, he's on a mad one right now. He's going absolutely crazy.
And Logix continued to terrorize Singularity support players.
Kellex, under assault from the tank, Tracer combination, and both supports are down.
To go up 2-0 in the series, Volskaya was completed in record time after Misfits held Singularity on point A, then finished the map in 47 seconds.
And Misfits making it look easy.
Dorada was shorter than usual too, as Singularity were able to get the payload halfway, but Misfits wasted no time on offense.
It's decisive, it's devastating, it's Misfits.
Misfits scored their third 4-0 sweep in a row. Gamers Origin versus Team Giganti was a close match out of the gate. Leafs, Doomfist, and Ben Best Reinhardt earned Gamers Origin a strong win on University.
The Shatter comes in!
But Linkster doubled his efforts on a City Center and then really showed off his skills on Gardens as the anti-pharmacy.
Linkster, wow. Anti-air Genji!
Not even 2 Big Bangs.
Somebody gonna be trying to connect with that Davin!
Could stop Gamers Origin on point A of King's Row.
Kaboom!
But Giganti were able to stop them before the end and saved an even bigger bang for their final victory push on offense.
Here comes the dragon, eating, and there's the bomb right on top.
Gamers Origin fired back on Hanamura, opening the match with this insane hardest headshot on Linkser.
Deadly.
Whoa, oh, what?
My word!
Get out of here, Hardis!
Linkser would get his revenge during the tiebreaker.
Oh, Hardis, 1v1, 1v1.
Oh!
Linkser with the thief legs.
But would fall again to a very different sniper.
He is still in the corner. What is going on here? The replay comes out. Oh! Sleep down onto Linkser.
Gamer's Origin would have gotten more than 69% on point B if not for the Zappis self-destruct.
That'll force him off the point. Oh! Tactics down, Zappis with 3K.
It would be enough as Giganti couldn't break through Gamer's Origin's point B defense.
And the dream, the hope, might still be alive for Gamer's Origin.
Damn it.
Because it's looking like, indeed, they will be taking Hanamura.
Linkser must have been triggered from getting killed by snipers on Hanamura, as his Widowmaker on Watchpoint Gibraltar was disgusting.
Linkser right now with room to work with. Now, who gets him?
Forced upon Bembest using his primal rage. Linkser, please, man, stop this madness. He's actually popping off.
Needless to say, Team Giganti would take the map with style, winning the series 3-1.
Beat down, not gonna be enough. Grappling hooks away. I mean, he's done it so many times. Linkser, please.
Now, let's take a look at the standings. Misfits in 1-2-3 lead the standings with Gamer's Origin, Team Giganti, and Cloud9 with their sights on the top. And now it's time for Europe's top five plays from week 3. Kicking off the countdown at number 5 is Special Delivery. Tonic had a special delivery for his 1-2-3 teammates, a quad kill pulse bomb from Volatalia.
Oh my god!
What?
Volatalia out of nowhere!
Number 4 is Cruisin' for a Bruisin'. Cruz had a few notable Dragon Blades against 1-2-3, but he wouldn't stand for Hafikul trying to steal his thunder as Cruz came out victorious in this Dragon Blade duel.
Cruz's blade came out first and slices down Hafikul in midair. That's what you like to see.
Top 10 anime battles right there, ladies and gentlemen.
Our number 3 play is not dead yet. Nevix was in complete control on Hanamura, overcoming a charging D.Va head-on, then countered with Attack Visor to remove Misfits from point B.
I'm not a fan of this one, lad. You just tried to take a fight with the devil. He's on the high ground CP, and he's making mincemeat of them.
The tracking just became a little bit more beautiful there. The Attack Visor came in. Plenty of room for Nevix.
Coming in at number 2 is Revenge is Sweet. Linkser had a rough time against snipers on Hanamura.
Oh, what? What is going on here? The replay comes out. Sleep down.
But he got his revenge on Gibraltar, getting too many headshots to highlight. But this 1v1 against Hardest Tracer was a cold dish of revenge.
Hardest, he's had enough, man. He wants to try and go over the kill. Beat down, not going to be enough. Grappling hooks away. I mean, he's done it so many times. Linkser, please.
And our number 1 play is, thank you, Zarya. Davin had a warm-up Big Bang on King's Row, but realized it wasn't good enough. Teaming up with Zarya for this 5-man pulse bomb, complete with the follow-up for a full team kill for Davin.
We like to talk about combinations. Well, Big Bang is on the menu again. There's a grab time. Davin, where are you? In from the top. Kaboom!
That's what you get. That's what you get. That's a 5K from Davin. 6K, the whole team wipe. You hear the dong. That's not Big Ben calling. That is indeed a 6K for Davin.
Thank you for watching the Overwatch Contenders Season 1 Europe Recap Show. Be sure to check out overwatchcontenders.com for all the latest information on the tournament. And now, your European Boop of the Week.
Crystal is so weak. Surely he can bring it
down.
Zeus gets booped off. Oh, there's your Boop of the Week, Boopasaurus, man.